Hello everyone. I'm Ted. And today we will discuss Chapter 20. Employee Empowerment, Downsizing and Work-Life Balance. Let's start. Downsizing. Downsizing. Thanks to global competition, every company is forced to remain lean and efficient in order to stay ahead of competition and serve customers well. Downsizing is a powerful tool in the hands of companies trying to remain efficient. Downsizing refers to a process where a company or a firm simply reduces its workforce in order to cut the operating costs and improve efficiency. Definition, simply stated, downsizing is the planned elimination of positions job in an organization. It is a technique to reorganize a company's internal operations aimed at reducing unwanted hands and improving profitability. Merits. 1. Impact on employer. Helps a company fight economic shocks and competitive attacks. Improve operational efficiencies. Market share improves. Lean and clean operations. Profitability improves. 2. Impact on workforce. Surplus staff facing pink slip forced to acquire new skills and find their feet in the marketplace. Labor mobility improves. 3. Impact on society. Survival of the fittest. Lean and profitable companies offering better customer service. Scarce resources of a country put to excellent use. Demerits. 1. Impact on employer. Morale of employees take a big hit. Difficulty in finding loyal and reliable employees. 2. Impact on workforce. Disruption of interpersonal relations within a company. Workers getting penalized for mistakes committed by top management. Staff who remain live with constant fear of job loss. Lower self-confidence and, as a result, employees turn risk-averse. 3. Impact on society. Greater unemployment. Lesser income levels and fall in standards of living. Social welfare expenses increase as governments might be forced to take care of displaced workers. Moving next. Reasons for downsizing. Reasons for downsizing. The important reasons for downsizing may be listed thus. Merging of two or more firms. Firms merge their operations to improve market share. When this happens, some positions become redundant. Some members might be asked to leave voluntarily. Other employees who are difficult to manage might be laid off compulsorily. Acquisition. If one organization purchases another one, there is a definite change in the management and the acquired company staff has to face unemployment. The reason for this is the same as the earlier case, that is, to cut costs and increase the revenues. Change in management. Whenever there is a change at the top level, companies resort to workforce reductions. The new management might have a different way of dealing with things and people. By eliminating unwanted hands, they want to show to the world that they mean business and they do not want to live with inefficiencies of any kind. Economic crisis, downsizing is carried out in case of crises of various kinds. Workforce reductions happen across the board and this might happen without any violent protests and demonstrations. Even reputed and popular firms resort to downsizing with a view to staying lean and efficient. Strategy changes, when companies want to concentrate on projects/products with high returns and put an end to those that are not so profitable, workforce reductions happen. Excessive workforce. In a period of high growth, a company hires excess staff to meet the needs of a growing business. However, in times of recession the business opportunities dwindle, leading to workforce reductions. Computerization, all over the globe, has compelled many companies to lop off unwanted hands. It is a typical case of an efficient machine eating away the jobs handled by too many inefficient hands consuming a huge amount of time. Where speed and efficiency are extremely important, computerization is the only way. Likewise, where costs have to be brought down to improve operational efficiencies, companies have to show the door to surplus staff. Outsourcing practice. To compete on a global scale, companies need to look at how their internal operations are carried out. Any jobs that can be handled effectively by specialist external agencies can be outsourced. Outsourcing, stated simply, is the contracting out of a company's non-core, non-revenue producing activities to specialists. Organizations catering to international markets require a huge and efficient employee base. If this labor can be obtained by exporting the job to other countries, a huge downsizing takes place in the parent country. For instance, if a certain job can be done more economically in India than in the United States, the business is operated from that country. Operational efficiency. A major benefit of downsizing is that it cuts flap and improves operational efficiency. The jobs that do not bring in returns and the non-core operations that could be turned over to external experts become the first targets in downsizing exercises. Non-performers are shown the door. Corporate resources are put to best use by focusing attention on core processes that a company can do better than its rivals. Moving next. Excessive workforce. In a period of high growth, a company hires excess staff for downsizing to meet the needs of a growing business.
Downsizing affects the morale of employees
in times of recession. The business opportunities dwindle,
leading to workforce reduction.
Because they may feel uncertain about whether or not they will continue to be employed.
All over the globe has compelled many companies to lock off unwanted hands.
With a huge batch of employees being relieved from employment on the same day,
handled by too many
other cases, hands consuming a huge amount of time.
Employers should remember that downsizing is very upsetting and stressful.
Computerization should take steps to conduct it smoothly.
Likewise, ensuring valued employees have
their jobs
down
to improve operational efficiency.
To avoid violent
protests, have to show the door to surplus staff.
The whole exercise needs to be carried out
following the rule
to compete on a global scale.
Advanced companies need to look at
how their internal operations are carried out
and why the company is forced to take such a step.
Any jobs that can be handled effectively by specialist external agencies
can be outsourced.
Informed about their future prospects in the company.
Stated simply,
severance packages
that are as per law,
in which adequately secure the
affected
employees
to specialists
till they find new jobs. To
organizations catering to international
markets require a huge
and efficient employee base. The criteria for laying off unwanted hands should also
be spelled out. If this labor can be obtained by exporting the job to other countries,
some companies also help surplus staff
find alternative jobs in the employment market throughout placement assistance.
For instance,
offering additional training,
job can
hiring a recruitment
consultant
who would find jobs to those
who may have to leave the organization for various reasons.
Counseling help
to get along with the resultant stress.
A major benefit of downsizing is that it
families
cuts flap
and improves operational efficiency.
The jobs that do not bring in returns and
moving
the non-core
next,
operations that could be turned over to external
downsizing
experts become
and HR.
The first targets in downsizing exercises.
Downsizing and HRs
are shown the door.
Downsizing often comes as a root shock
for the affected workers.
By focusing attention on
the
core
other processes
who
that
a
company
behind
can
are forced
do better
to
than
grapple
with an uncertain work environment, as well as unreliable and unrealistic expectations from the management. Many talented employees quit the company in alarm. The aftermath of downsizing is a wounded workforce that is stressed and demotivated. The HR needs to play a key leadership role and take a constructive approach before, during and after the downsizing initiative to improve sentiments and bring everything back to normalcy. Important HR initiatives in this connection include employee involvement. HR should take all affected employees into confidence and explain the purpose of downsizing. The concerns of victims need to be looked into closely. The severance package should be designed in a fair way. The other employees need to be assured that such things do not get repeated in the near future, and that the management has done everything in an equitable manner. Communication. Employees do not want to be kept in the dark on issues affecting their livelihood. This will only breed mistrust in management and dampen their spirits considerably. A candid, two-way communication exercise would help in explaining why downsizing is taking place, what would happen to those who are asked to leave, how it benefits the organization, and what is the immediate next step. Support programs and selection processes. The organization must help separating employees find their feet in the market, especially in their search for new employment. The supportive effort may cover career counseling, stress management, outplacement assistance, and financial planning before and after the downsizing. While identifying the at-risk employees, strict adherence to ethical values, moral standards, and well-established procedures is essential. Survivors must be assured that the layoff policy is a fair one and is not being colored by personal biases. While drawing the curtain between at-risk employees and separating employees, it is always better to explain the selection criteria and encourage employees to discuss their fears openly. Human resource management tools and systems alignment. During a downsizing initiative, HR managers should also focus on aligning HR programs, policies, and systems with a lean and healthy-looking outfit. In an attempt to build confidence and earn the trust of survivors, new initiatives in the form of stock options and profit-sharing plans could be introduced, thus demonstrating that any constructive effort in rebuilding the organization would be appropriately rewarded. To ease the pressure, flexible schedules could be
training
planned
and development.
Daycare slash elder care clinics could be helped to adjust to the new challenges brought in by a new look organization and its culture.
To think and act independently.
To this end,
keeping
training
the best
and skills
and
knowledge
upgradation
must be offered almost simultaneously. Employees must also be equipped with the attitude, language, and tools needed to handle the emerging and future challenges. This would certainly jack up training and development budgets of organizations. However, the effort would pay off in the long run because employees would be better equipped to handle future challenges with relative ease and comfort. Job massacres may help reduce costs, but the side effects are disproportionately high. If not handled properly, top talent will vanish within no time. Saddled with heavier workloads, survivors may become victims of stress and burnout sooner than expected. If no alternative to layoffs exist, HR managers can make them seem less arbitrary and cruel by keeping the communication lines open and explaining with dignity the strategy behind them. They can provide outplacement services, generous severance pay, and family counseling. They can also offer resources for self-evaluation and employee retraining or job redeployment to enhance skills that will make the fired worker more employable, easing the transition to another job. If they cannot guarantee employment, they can at least guarantee employability. Moving next. Work-life balance. Work-life balance. Work-life and personal life are two sides of a coin. In the name of becoming career racehorses, one should not burn out too soon. Too much work without any fun would send people to their graves sooner than expected. Work can also be enjoyed. Factories and offices can be turned into enjoyable and exciting places of work if there is support from the top. Maintaining work-life balance, therefore, has become a priority area for HR managers these days. What do you mean by work-life balance? Work-life balance does not mean slicing out equal number of hours for each of your work and personal activities, which is highly unlikely in the real world. Also, an individual's work-life balance will vary with time. The right balance for you when you are single will be different when you marry, and it changes again when you are blessed with children, and again when you are nearing retirement. There is no perfect, one-size-fits-all balance you should be striving for. In fact, achievement and enjoyment are the two sides of an acceptable definition of work-life balance. A good working definition of work-life balance is meaningful daily achievement and enjoyment in each of my four life quadrants: work, family, friends, and self. At work, you can create your own best work-life balance by making sure you not only achieve, but also reflect the joy of the job, and the joy of life, every day. If nobody pats you on the back today, pat yourself on the back. And help others to do the same. When you do, when you are a person that not only gets things done, but also enjoys the doing, it attracts people to you. They want you on their team and they want to be on your team. Let us take a close look at the issue of work-life balance and the factors behind related problems. Hectic schedules. With hectic schedules, high-pressure work assignments and deadly targets, you have to race against time to get noticed and be in the reckoning. Otherwise, you will be labeled a poor performer. Intense competition. In recent years, the lives of executives have been thrown out of gear completely, thanks to the intense competitive environment, the proliferation of information technology, and instant, 24/7 connectivity. Thus, there is an urgent need to strike a balance between an executive's career and ambition on one hand, and pleasure, leisure, family, and spiritual development on the other hand. Very little time to relax. The 50-70-hour work weeks have become common these days. Not only that, it's simply not sufficient to work. You need to work hard and work smart to get ahead of others, and executives are burning their candle of energies too soon. Run that extra mile to deliver results. To deliver results, you are forced to run that extra mile very fast, sacrificing family, relationships, friends, community work, leisure, pleasure, and everything that brings meaning, happiness and fulfillment to life. Remember the famous words, "What's this life, full of care, there is no time to stand and stare." Weekend parents, in the case of dual career couples, a common phenomenon in the 21st century, parents are unable to devote time to their children, and are reduced to what is popularly known as weekend parents. Mental wrecks, workaholics who are unable to strike a fine balance between work pressures and personal and family issues, often go on to suffer from heart ailments, cardiovascular problems, sleep disorders, depression, jumpiness, irritability, insecurity, poor concentration, and even nervous breakdowns. Unhealthy habits, a time will come when they lose emotional balance, get irritated over petty issues, indulge in verbal abuse, and when stress begins to work on their nerves, they begin to destroy their personal lives through excessive smoking, drinking, and gambling. No one knows how many kids are home after school, without an adult, but the number is the millions. These children spend time on video games, TV, and the internet, with damaging impacts on their psychological growth and development. It is not a healthy sign from the employer's point of view also. Stress and burnout. Executive stress and burnout would lead to a lot of problems on the behavioral front. The race for grabbing space, facilities, opportunities, and media attention does not end usually with high performance. It actually breeds anger, frustration, and resentment among colleagues, leading to a kind of tug of war for everything. The resultant political behavior would bring down overall performance substantially. The practical side of the coin. Western countries make it mandatory for businesses to extend work-life balance to their employees. In addition, active groups such as the Employers for Work-Life Balance in the UK and Center for Work-Life Policy in the US support the cause and ensure a fair play in the larger interests of millions of workers. Globalization has made an employee's life very tough in India in recent times. They have to work under three different time zones, conforming to the time of Europe, US and Asia, and in many cases, working night shifts has, more or less, become a routine. In service industries, extensive travel has become the order of the day. The onslaught from technology in the form of cell phones, internet and emails has literally converted ordinary employees into economic slaves of industry. The entry of educated women has brought in additional complexities into the work spot in the form of creation of creches, anti-sexual harassment drives, medical facilities to elders and children at home, maternity leave, etc. Telecommuting facility extended to employees in MNCs and large Indian companies such as HP, Mindtree, Wipro, Infosys and IBM has eased the pressure a bit. But, as things stand today, no employee can proudly declare that he or she is free from all kinds of work-related problems and tensions at least one day a week. Companies such as TCS, Microsoft India, IGATE Global Solutions, HCL Infosystems, HSBC, Marriott Hotels India, Godrej Consumer Products, Google India, Max New York Life, Eli Lilly, Canon India, Sapient, Infosys are trying their best to correct the situation. They are trying every trick in the book to cheer up stressed and overworked employees through novel policies and funny ideas. In a tough competitive terrain, Indian employers are not leaving anything to chance. Employees are pampered like never before. The bouquet of benefits, facilities, and personal services being offered by most companies to woo employees is more or less the same. The focus has shifted from the what to the how to make every touch point between the organization and the employees an experience that lets them know how valuable they are. Strategies to strike a balance. 1. Budget your time both in and out of the office. Schedule your time efficiently at work, put yourself on your calendar and take some time for you and your family/friends. Leave work on time at least 3 days per week. There are times when working late just can't be helped, but schedule your time to leave on time 3 days per week. 2. Control interruptions and distractions, stay focused while in the office, and budget your time effectively. Try to schedule a block of time during the day without meetings when you CGN, focus on your tasks with minimal interruptions. 3. Explore the availability of flex time, research flex time options within your organization. If available, it may be a helpful solution. 4. Seize the weekend, plan your time off as you plan your work week. Learn to say no if required. Sharing the responsibilities will help. And do not commit for something which is practically not possible to achieve. 5. Schedule activities with family and friends, a weekend trip, or just something fun. Make your time away from work count. That's all for this video. Thank you for watching. This video is brought to you by Bookstune. Like this video to encourage us. Share this video to spread the knowledge. And subscribe to this channel for latest update.